Awesome. Thank you, Fee, and thanks, everyone. If there's a problem with hearing me, I hope my connection doesn't cut out, should be fine. I'm going to start with what it is that when people ask, what is it that you do? And I can honestly say this was probably one of the scariest things that I found when I first started. I actually would sort of walk away from people at the park thinking, oh, don't ask me what I do, because I really didn't have it prepared. But it's a really important skill that we have to master in this business. So it's probably one of the most important things that you can, if you're in recruit mode, obviously when you're having those conversations with people at the park, or, you know, school moms, or, you know, anyone, family and friends, you just want to have something quick, rolls off the tongue. You've got belief in yourself. You've got conviction in your voice. You want people just to believe in you, and they're not going to follow you or think what you've got is gold if you're not confident. So basically you've got 30 seconds to inspire and create curiosity. That's our job, right? We want to create curiosity, and we're adding value to people's lives. So I think people often freeze up when they say, what is it that you do? And probably people do make a mistake of mentioning Juice Plus, and have you heard of Juice Plus? But we don't sort of go down that road. We want to create curiosity and intrigue. So basically today I'll just give you a bit of a brief, some tips and tricks that I have looked into or used myself, or from use from the team's advice. I honestly was petrified of this in the beginning, but I feel like once the more you do it, more you have those conversations with people, you just develop that confidence. And it's sort of like you develop the confidence on the way. You can't just sit back and think, oh, when I'm confident, I'll do that. You need to do it, and then the confidence comes. So I would really get the verbiage right. I think the most important thing to do is really become clear on who your tribe is and what your values are. That's the two biggest things. You need to get clear, crystal clear on what your values are. For me, family, so important to me, and I'm sure everyone's family is important, but to me, I really, really, really joined this business because I want to work at home with my little boy. I don't want him to go to childcare because I used to work as a director in childcare, and I'm very passionate about being home with him. So my tribe is stay-at-home mums, and I really, really wanted to get that message across. So I would definitely mention, when they ask me what it is I do, something about being able to drop off my kids and do school pickups and working from my phone at home in stolen moments. So once you're clear on your values, I know for me, family and your tribe, who you're trying to target or attract, stay-at-home mums for me, but I really want to attract stay-at-home mums that have lost their identity, that have... they need to find themselves again, and they want more out of life. So that's my tribe. And probably the most important thing is authenticity. So important. People can see straight through you if you're not being authentic. It needs to be in alignment with your values and what's authentic to you. There is no point in me using Fee's story or her values are totally different. She's very into health and fitness, and I love it too, but that's not me. So I would definitely not use Fee's elevator pitch. We call it elevator pitch. Because think yourself, you get in the elevator, you've got 30 seconds. What are you going to say? Someone asks you what you do. So it doesn't have to be long. It just has to be inspiring. And you can work on this with your upline or someone that you resonate in the business if you really have trouble with this. And you certainly don't, it's not set in stone. You can change it, and you would change it depending on who you're talking to. If I talk to a mum who has no kids, I'm not going to sort of go straight for working from home with my kids, because it's not going to mean anything to her. So you would pick up, you'd have a few up your sleeve, and I'm going to go through a few examples. But I think probably the most important thing is conviction, certainty. Would you be inspired by you? Are you inspiring? Take a look at yourself. Is that inspiring? Would you follow you? So I would sort of say I own an online health and wellness business where I inspire women or mums to be the best version of themselves, there's plenty of examples. You could sort of use, I coach, I mentor, I inspire, I help, I work with. So I would just brainstorm, jot down some ideas and things that really mean to you. But definitely you could sort of say, I own a global online health and wellness biz where I inspire other mums to find their passions and purpose in life again. That sort of resonates with me, because I was that mum. I had a four-month-old baby when I found this business, and I was really feeling lost. I couldn't go back to my teaching job, and I really am passionate about helping other mums find their purpose and passion in life again. And they're not just a mum. You're much more than that. It's so important, that role being a mum, but you don't want to lose your identity. So yeah, I really have a few up my sleeve, but that's probably the one I resonate with. If you, when you're saying you have a global online health and wellness biz, that certainly creates curiosity and intrigue. People want to know more. The goal is you want people to ask more questions. But yeah, I would, you could also say you inspire healthy living on a global scale, or healthy living around the world. You help other mums work from home around their kids. There's so many things you can use, but I like helping mums, or helping women become the best versions of themselves, because that's what we do. We definitely want people to, and you help people become a healthier, more fulfilled version of themselves, and by offering them an opportunity to work from home. So there are so many things that I can go through, but I really don't want to go into too much detail. But if you know where you're going, if your vision's clear, you're going to attract team to you. So I think that's really important. How are you delivering it when someone asks you? Are you shy, and are you quiet, and are you not seeming certain of yourself? I think you need to keep saying it over and over. Say it in the shower, I don't know. So yeah, basically, I'm happy. Anyone else want to put their elevator pitches in the comments? It's good to hear other people's, because we all have different values, we all have different tribes. So but I think I run an online whole food nutrition business where I help mums do mum care instead of daycare. So yeah, it'd be great to hear other people's in the comments, because I think that we can learn a lot from each other. So yeah, so if you're not going to paint the vision early for other people, if you're not going to attract people to you, if you're not being inspiring and certain. So that's pretty much all I had on that topic, but I've got heaps to say on the three-way call. So Fee, do you want to add anything about the elevator pitch? I suppose I was just going to say, if people want to know more, I wouldn't just stand there and talk more about it. I'd ask them questions, and what is it you do, and do you love what you do, and finding their pain and asking them questions about what it is they do, because you just certainly don't want to be standing there talking all about your business and opportunity. But I'm going to jump into the three-way calls if no one has anything else they wanted to add, or just keep adding your comments in there. Three-way calls. I love three-way calls. I was excited about this because I feel they are such a successful way to build your business. It's a high-paying activity. I mean, if you're not using three-way calls, you're absolutely crazy. Even myself now, I'll get Tanya or Mel or someone that resonates with the person that I'm trying to recruit or bring into my team. You definitely, I've been in the business nearly 18 months or something, and I still would definitely use people. If I can't get someone across the line, like if they need to hear someone else's story, or so they're so important. So do you guys love them or do you hate them? I mean, I love them. They're awesome in just for so many reasons. So basically I tell my team to plug their potentials in with me for using three-way calls for product and for business, because I've had really good success with them. So why would you use them? In the beginning, I thought they were cheesy, and I wondered, why do we need to use someone else to help us make a decision? I just didn't really get it. I can relate if you're hesitant with using them, because it can be a bit daunting and it can be scary for the person. I usually sort of tell my team to not mention it to the person, because they'll definitely not want to get on the call. And I've never had any negative feedback when I'm doing it with my team. I've never had anyone not be happy about me jumping on the call with them. So, once I learnt more and become a student of the industry, I soon realised the power of the three-way call. And I'm going to sort of break it down now. Basically, it's not because I'm not good enough at explaining it if I'm using someone else. It's because you need that third-party validation. So it's a game-changer for people you're talking to when you have that third party. It's psychology. Like when we see somebody else loving something, it becomes a little more interesting. And it's like, I heard this story on YouTube. I was watching this clip and this girl was telling a story about the purple purse. So, you see a purple purse on sale on the clearance table and you look at it and think, oh, that's cute. And then someone else walks over to it and you think, oh, hang on, someone else likes it too. And then a whole swarm of women come over to it and everyone wants that purple purse, and it creates that urgency. And you can sort of relate it to this, because that third party validation's come in and like everyone wants the same purse. So, yeah, if you put it that way, it makes sense. So basically, why do we use them and what is a three-way call? A three-way call is an opportunity for your guest or your potential to connect with someone in the business that's more successful or more, it's been in the business longer, like a leader. And it's a chance for them to learn more about and make a decision from learn more about the product or the business. So it's really a great tool that you can use for someone that wants to know more. So the reason it works is because the person, the leader that you're plugging the person in with has conviction. They have certainty. They know what this business can do for them. They know what this product has done for them. They can share their story. So we all know facts tell, stories sell. Like people know they should eat more fruit and veggies. They know that how good they are for them, but that's boring. You want to hear the stories of how people have had, like my son's anxiety story, or you want to hear improved health. And it's just stories are the thing that is really going to intrigue people. And, you know, they want to hear how this product has helped people with conditions, certain conditions. So yeah, the conviction, the belief in the product, the belief in the industry, and just having that, what the potential it can do from them. The person that's been in the business longer has more experience, and it's great for new team also to jump on the call with and hear how the leader conducts the call. So they're learning what to say. They're learning how to answer objections, how to handle the objections. And the most important thing, they're learning how to conquer the close or how to close on the sale as such. I mean, we don't like to say we're salespeople, but really we are in sales. So yeah, the process to go through. I'm not going to go through every single thing, but most people have an iPhone or the Samsung. The iPhone, you can merge calls on the iPhone, but the Samsung, you probably need to use Messenger. And you can, I've got team who use Messenger and don't have an iPhone, and it works fine. The person that's inviting the potential to the call would just set up a three-way Messenger chat, and then you can do the video call through that. So yeah, the process is really simple. Set up a time with your potential and with your upline who wants to know the upline and the potential that wants to know more. So you basically would make a connection and introduce the potential to the leader. You could sort of say to them a little bit about how I'd love to introduce you to my business partner. This is Fiona. She's been in the industry for 16 months. She'll be able to answer your questions. I'm only new to the business and I'd love her to share her story with you. She's got an amazing story and I hope, you know, you just introduce it that way. And I would say to, I'm just going to check my notes. So that's something to come back to. So as a leader, I'm assuming that the person that I'm jumping on the call with already has watched a link. They already have asked questions. They've shown the interest in the business or the product. It's not their first time hearing about it because the three-way call is not used as a first time hearing about the business or the product. It's definitely someone that wants to know more and is excited to learn more. They've watched the link on the product or the business. Yeah, so that's really important. So I would sort of ask, when I'm doing the three-way call, I'd ask the person, what intrigued you to find out more about the product or the business? So you want to, as a leader, you want to know where their interest is. You're not going to go and talk about the business if it's only the product they're interested in. I mean, I'd certainly still mention it, but you want to find out where you're going to go with the call and you're going to listen. We're not going to talk the whole time. We're listening to, we're asking good questions and we're allowing the prospect to talk first. And that's going to help us lead in with our story and weave our story into the three-way call. And you want to, yeah, so that it really gives you a way to know how to weave your story in there. Yeah, so you're going to create urgency. So that's what you're going to answer the questions that the potential has. And after you've shared your story, you're going to answer the questions. And my team, I do them all the time with my team. I did one last night for one of my new team and it was awesome. They're so successful because you just let the person share what they're interested to know more about. And I can come in with my experience with what there's links I can help my team member find that this girl was pregnant. So we found some amazing, the JP call and the girls just want to have funds with the fertility link. So it was awesome. I helped her find the correct information and then helped answer the questions. And I shared stories about people that I know in the business who are pregnant or who have been pregnant and have had great results with their baby. And yeah, so I've pretty much got, I think I've gone through most of my notes, but if she needs more information or he when you get off the call, I always close with, where are you sitting between a 1 and a 10? A 10 getting started, or, you know, 5, need to know more? Or so basically you find out, are they keen to jump in to get their order set up straight away, or do they need to know more? And if they need to know more, that's when you can help direct your teamie to find that information. And you can actually reschedule. Would it be okay, I'll touch base with you again tomorrow, or once you've watched the link, or once you've had your questions answered. And yeah, so that's a really successful way. But I always leave the team member with the person at the end. And once I've found out whether they need more information or whether they're ready to get started. So yeah, creating urgency is really important. You would never leave the call open for like, oh, yep, I'll see what you think. Or just, you don't want to be wishy-washy. You want to be certain with, I'll touch base with you again in 24 hours or 48 hours. If she's not interested in the business and it's just product, that's fine. You can definitely mention the business, but you wouldn't be pushing on about the product or the business if she hasn't said she's interested. So does anyone have any questions or feed? Do you want to add anything? I think I've mentioned most things I was going to talk about.